Hi everyone. For this video, I wanted to do this linear algebra proof. If anyone is watching this video who's a subscriber to me, I am back, at least for this video. So I think I haven't made a YouTube video in about a year or two. I haven't checked yet. And so I'm back from the dead. I'm sure the YouTube algorithm had all but given up on me. They probably thought I had, maybe died or something, but I've been alive this whole time. And I thought I would make a video. I don't know. I just am on and off sometimes, but I did feel like making a video for the first time in a while. So anyway, for this video, we're going to do this linear algebra proof. It says, let A be an n by n matrix, so a square matrix. Prove that there exists two n by n matrices, P and Q, such that P transpose is equal to P, and Q transpose is equal to negative Q, and A is equal to P plus Q. So to begin this proof, I'm just going to rewrite everything that we're given. So we are given that A is equal to P plus Q, where P transpose is equal to P. So this means that P is a symmetric matrix. So when the transpose of a matrix is equal to itself, that means it's symmetric. And we have a skew-symmetric matrix. So QT is equal to negative Q, and that property means that it's skew-symmetric. This is just asking us to prove a well-known property of all square matrices, which is that all square matrices can be decomposed into the sum of a symmetric matrix and a skew-symmetric matrix. So this is something that we can prove, and we're being asked to prove it in this problem. So how are we going to prove that this property is true? One thing we're going to try is we're going to take the transpose of A. So that's going to be equal to the transpose of P plus Q. Then we're just going to distribute the transpose property. So the transpose of the sum of two matrices is equal to the sum of the transpose matrices. So that's going to be equal to PT plus QT. We know that P transpose is equal to P, and we know that Q transpose is equal to negative Q. So we can write P transpose as P minus Q. And so we have that A is equal to P plus Q. And we have also true that A transpose is equal to P minus Q. From here, we can see that we can cancel out or solve for P and Q just using these two equations that we have. So if we add A transpose and A, we can see that we have a positive Q and a minus Q. So if we add those, they're going to subtract and equal zero, and then we'll get P and we can solve for P. And similarly, if we subtract A transpose from A, then we'll get P minus P and Q plus Q, so then we can solve for Q. So I'm going to go ahead and do those two combinations. I'm going to do A plus A transpose, which is going to be equal to P plus Q plus P minus Q. So that's going to give me 2P plus 0 is equal to A plus A transpose, which means that P is equal to 1/2 A plus A transpose. So we've solved for P, and to solve for Q, I'm going to take A minus A transpose. That's going to give me P plus Q minus P minus Q. That's going to equal P plus Q minus P plus Q. So that's going to give me 2Q is equal to A minus A transpose, which means that Q is equal to 1/2 A minus A transpose. So we've solved for P and Q. And then let's just go ahead in the final part of this video and prove that Q transpose is equal to negative Q and P transpose is equal to P. So therefore, P transpose is going to be equal to the transpose of 1/2 A plus A transpose. So I'm going to take the transpose of this entire piece. That's going to be equal to 1/2 A transpose plus A, which is exactly equal to P. And Q transpose is going to equal to the transpose of 1/2 times A minus A transpose, which is equal to 1/2 A transpose minus A, which is equal to negative 1/2 A minus A transpose, which is equal to negative Q. And we are done with this problem.